Lehmar GmbH, general importer for Marsars ice rescue systems in Europe. We launch your wishes. Ice rescue with state-of-the-art equipment. Wintertime, ice skating time. Every year during the wintertime, many people are magically drawn onto the glittery surfaces of frozen lakes. But children, and also grown-ups, overestimate the bearing capacity of the ice layer and break through the surface. Due to the fast drop of body temperature, rescue forces only have a matter of minutes to save people from the ice-cold water. Thus, saving devices that are quickly operational and proper and safe rescuing techniques are vital. Still at the fire station or on their way to the place of action, the rescuers have already put on their survival suits that are worn over their regular clothes without shoes. Most importantly, before a mission begins, is the own safeguarding of the rescue forces that will be going onto the ice surface. The person who secures the lead attaches the rescue and retaining end of the lead to the hoisting rope of the ice rescue sled. The rescuer secures him or herself by connecting the safety belt of the ice rescue sled to his or her survival suit. Important, the carabiner of the rescue belt is attached both to the ring and to the carabiner of the life belt. To securely affix the reel of the lead, an ice anchor is driven through the ice. Here, the reel is attached by a loop. The rescuer has three options of getting to the casualty by using the rescue sled. 1. The sled can be carried. 2. The rescuer lies on the sled and moves forward by using the ice awls. 3. The sled is pulled, in which case the pulling loop must be released on the lower side. The rescuer must decide how to rescue the casualty swiftly and without endangering him or herself by evaluating the structural conditions on site. From a safe distance, roughly 2 meters away from the casualty, the rescuer should try to calm the person in the ice-cold water down and ask how physically fit he or she is. This is important to the further course of the rescue mission. Should the person be able to help the rescuer actively by lifting his or her arms, the rescue continues via the ice rescue sled. The rescuer leaves the board, releases the rescue arm loop and the safety belt of the sled. Now the rescuer pushes the sled towards the person in the water, whilst commanding the person to pass their arms crosswise through the loop. After this procedure, the rescuer releases the hoisting rope on the lower side of the sledge and beckons his colleague, who secures the lead, to quickly pull the lead by shouting or waving to him. In this process, the rescued person and the ice rescue sled are wound up against each other. In the case of a stable edge, the rescuer can lift the front of the sledge to support it. If the ice is unstable, the sled will prop itself up due to the weight pressure of one person, and on secure ice it will lie on the surface. The rescuer lets the sled with the rescued person pass by and holds on to the rear handles. Should the rescuer notice that the casualty is unable to lift his or her arms due to hypothermia, the rescue happens by means of the rescue sling. The rescuer then crawls with the ice rescue sling to the casualty, lifts his or her right arm and leads it and his or her head through the sling. Then the rescuer holds the sling and the arm of the person with one hand and pulls the second arm through the sling. The rescuer then grabs the Velcro tape below the sling, releases it and tightens the rescue sling by pulling both ends to the body width of the person who is to be rescued. He then affixes the Velcro tape on the upper side. Then the rescuer pulls the sled towards himself, releases the rescue sling and the hoisting rope on the lower side of the sled, and attaches the rescue sling to the lug, which is located before the arm loop. The rescuer then beckons the colleague who secures the lead to quickly pull the lead by shouting or waving to him. As in the first example, the person is pulled out of the water. In the safety of the bank, the rescued person is then wrapped in an insulation blanket and then carried by 4 people to the ambulance with an emergency doctor. Should a crane be needed, as in harbors, the rescue mission can also be undertook with the means of a 4-to-1 lifting gear. Should a second team be called to the rescue site in order to save more than one person, or the rescue sled not be available for saving further people, the rescue happens with the help of the rescue sling and the specially for these situations designed rescue and retaining lead. The rescuer attaches the rescue sling to the second end of the rescue and retaining lead and secures himself by connecting the carabiner with his survival suit. Important: the carabiner of the lead must be affixed through the ring and the carabiner of the life belt. The rescuer crawls with a rescue sling to the person who has fallen through the layer of ice, then lifts his or her right arm and leads the arm and the head through the sling. Then the rescuer holds the sling and the arm of the person with one hand and pulls the second arm through the sling. The rescuer then grabs the Velcro tape below the sling, releases it and tightens the rescue loop by pulling both ends to the body width of the person who is to be rescued. He then affixes the Velcro tape on the upper side. The rescuer then slides into the water next to the casualty. He presses the head of the person onto his arms and beckons the colleague who secures the lead to quickly pull the lead by shouting or waving to him. In order to support the person, the rescuer lifts the legs of the casualty in order to enable a more gentle recovery in a diagonal position. Once both rescuer and the rescued person are on stable ice, the rescued person can carefully be relocated. In this video, we demonstrated the handling of ice rescue systems with its main components: the ice rescue safety sled, the rescue sling, and the rescue and retaining lead on reel. This is not an educational or training video. This video may be used to support educational or training purposes by qualified personnel. Let us instruct you and your personnel for secure and efficient handling of the ice rescue system. Send your inquiries to Lehmar GmbH am Mirower Kanal 9, 17248 Rechlin.